Hello everyone, and welcome to How-FixIT. Today, we're taking apart the brand new Nintendo Switch 2 to see what's inside and how it compares to the original Switch. From hardware changes to repairability, let's dive into this teardown and find out what's truly new in Nintendo's latest console. To disassemble the Switch 2, you will need a tri-wing and Phillips 1 screwdriver, plastic pry tools, and a pair of tweezers. I left links to the necessary tools in the video description below. Okay, let's dive in. Let's start by removing the Joy-Cons. If you decide to disassemble your Switch, make sure to power off the console completely beforehand. Lift the kickstand and remove the two screws using a tri-wing screwdriver. Next, remove the two screws near the charging port at the bottom of the console, as well as the single screw located at the top edge of the case. Now, we need to peel off these stickers. To remove them carefully, use a pair of curved tweezers. Start by prying up the sticker from the inner side near the Joy-Con connector. Insert a second pair of tweezers in the small gap and begin peeling the sticker along the edge of the chassis. This is how easily you can remove the stickers without causing any damage. Remove the second sticker using the same method. Remove the two screws located beneath each of the stickers on both sides. Use a plastic spudger to gently pry up the bottom cover. Then, release the latches through the small openings to remove the back cover. After removing the bottom cover of the Switch 2 and the original Switch, you can see some similarities in their internal architecture. Both have a large metal plate, and both feature a microSD slot. As with the original Switch, the Switch 2 has the microSD slot implemented as a separate module, making it easy to replace if it becomes damaged. Let's remove this plate and see what's inside. Remove the screws securing the antenna modules, then disconnect the antenna wires from the main board before proceeding to remove the metal plate. Use a plastic spatula to gently lift the metal plate from this side. Thermal putty slightly holds it in place. Always disconnect the battery cable from the motherboard before continuing with disassembly to prevent short circuits. Comparing the internal components of the Nintendo Switch 2 with those of the original Switch, we can observe several notable differences. The Switch 2 features a slightly larger heat pipe, an expected upgrade given the more powerful GPU. Thermal putty is still used to transfer heat to the metal plate, and the Switch 2 now includes a larger fan, which should improve overall cooling performance. Regarding the battery, the original switch appears to have a physically larger battery, which might suggest a higher milliampere hour capacity. However, upon closer inspection, the Switch 2 actually contains a 5,220 mAh battery, compared to the 4,310 mAh battery in the original Switch. So, despite being smaller in size, the Switch 2 battery offers a higher charge capacity. Let's continue the disassembly by removing the cooling system. The heat pipe in the Switch 2 is extremely thin, so it must be handled with great care. Heat pipes are hollow and contain a special cooling fluid. If bent, they lose their ability to effectively transfer heat to the heat sink. The heat pipe is held with thermal paste and double-sided thermal tape beneath the heat sink. To remove it safely without causing damage, use two plastic spatulas, one on each side, to apply even pressure. Gently lift the heat pipe to loosen it, but do not remove it completely until the heatsink has been fully detached from the double-sided thermal tape. Remove the three screws securing the cooling fan. Open the connector latch, disconnect the fan cable, and remove the fan. Delta's cooling fan is a very compact but relatively powerful 5-volt centrifugal blower that pushes roughly twice the air and static pressure of Delta's everyday 50mm laptop fans, making it a solid choice for tightly packed handhelds and thin devices like Switch 2. Unscrew the single screw, disconnect the cable from the main board, and remove the headphone jack module. Disconnect the ribbon cable from the main board and remove the top microphone. Disconnect the flex cable for the power and volume buttons. If one of the buttons is damaged or malfunctions, this cable can be easily replaced without the need for soldering or costly repairs. This represents a positive step toward more repair-friendly design. Disconnect the speaker cables and remove the speakers from the housing. The Switch 2 now features larger, enclosed speakers that are likely to deliver improved sound quality. In contrast, the original Switch had smaller speakers, and earlier versions lacked enclosures. Let's move on to removing the Switch 2 main board. First, disconnect the two cables from the Joy-Con connectors, as well as the display cable. Next, unscrew the six screws securing the main board to the console chassis. Gently pry up the main board using a plastic tool at the top edge and carefully lift it out of the case. Note that removing the board may require some effort, as two thermal pads on the backside hold it in place. Remove the two screws securing the Joy-Con connector, then unstick ribbon cable and remove the connector from the console housing. The easily replaceable Joy-Con connector on the Nintendo Switch 2 represents a significant improvement in repair-friendly design. This component is prone to wear and potential damage over time, but its modular construction makes maintenance much more accessible. Since it only requires the removal of two screws and involves no soldering, it greatly simplifies DIY repairs. The battery remains attached to the console chassis and is firmly secured with double-sided tape. If you need to replace it, check out my dedicated Switch 2 battery replacement guide. I'll also create a separate video on replacing the Switch 2 screen, as that process requires special attention. Links to both videos will be provided in the description below. The final replaceable components on the console chassis are the neodymium magnets that hold the Joy-Cons in place. While it's unclear under what circumstances these magnets might need replacement, they can be easily removed and replaced by unscrewing a single screw. Let's return to the motherboard and take a closer look. As with the original Switch, the graphics chip is covered by a metal shield. While it can be removed, it's best to do so using a plastic tool to avoid damaging the components. And here is the NVIDIA T239 chip, designed for the Nintendo Switch 2. It features an 8-core ARM CPU and an Ampere-based GPU with 1,536 CUDA cores, along with support for ray tracing and DLSS. According to NVIDIA, it delivers roughly 10 times the graphics performance of the original Switch. Next to the graphics chip are two SK Hynix memory chips, supporting 12GB of LPDDR5X memory on a 128-bit bus. On the backside of the motherboard are SK Hynix 256GB NAND memory chips, along with the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth modules, power management components, and an audio codec, all of which are also covered by metal shields. The Nintendo Switch 2 now features two USB-C ports, which is great. However, they are soldered directly to the motherboard, so replacing them requires a soldering iron and some expertise. One of the biggest downsides of the Switch 2 is its non-removable game cartridge slot. Unlike the original Switch, which featured a separate replaceable module, the Switch 2 has the cartridge slot soldered directly to the motherboard. If the slot becomes damaged, you'll likely need to take the console to a service center for repairs, which can be costly. This is definitely a step backward in terms of repairability, especially for a component that is used so frequently. Alright, we're finished with the console. Now let's take a look at the Joy-Con. Remove the side panel on the Joy-Con and unscrew the two screws. Then, remove two additional screws on the opposite side of the Joy-Con. Using a plastic spatula, carefully pry off the back cover. Opening the Joy-Con reveals the battery and vibration motor mounted on the back cover. Let's disconnect the battery and vibration module cables and compare them to those in the Joy-Con from the original Switch. The batteries look very similar in size, but the main board in the original Joy-Con looks larger. Let's take the disassembly further and see what's inside. Unscrew the screws and remove the Z, L, and L buttons. Then, disconnect the cables from the board and remove the panel with the battery. Disconnect the side rail and the analog stick flex cables from the Joy-Con board. Next, unscrew 5 more screws to remove the board from the case. The side rail includes a laser that functions like a computer mouse, as well as a connection port. On the back of the Joy-Con board, you'll find the control buttons. Now, just two screws are remaining to remove the analog stick module. The analog stick is still a modular component that can be replaced in about 5 minutes. It's great to see that Nintendo kept the analog stick modular in the Switch 2, as it remains one of the most commonly failing parts of the original Switch. Let's summarize. The microSD slot is modular and easily replaceable, requiring minimal effort and no complex repair process. The headphone jack and top microphone are also modular, making them simple to replace if needed. The Joy-Con connector can be replaced without soldering, and the process is quick and straightforward. The power and volume buttons are mounted on a flexible cable that can be easily swapped out by just opening the console case. All components of the Joy-Con are modular, including the analog stick, a commonly worn-out part, which remains user-replaceable in just a few minutes. The Switch 2 now features enclosed speakers, which significantly improve sound quality and volume. The cooling system includes a relatively powerful fan, however, the heat pipe is extremely thin and requires careful handling to maintain its thermal efficiency. The Switch 2 now includes two USB-C ports. While this is a welcome upgrade, replacing these ports requires some soldering skills. Notable disadvantages include the game cartridge slot being soldered directly to the main board, making replacement difficult and requiring advanced soldering expertise. Additionally, the battery is firmly glued to the chassis, which complicates the replacement process and requires caution and time. Overall, while the Nintendo Switch 2 shows several improvements in modularity and repair accessibility, particularly with the Joy-Con and other peripheral components, it also introduces a few drawbacks that reduce repairability in key areas. The reassembly process of the Switch 2, including thermal paste and thermal putty replacement, I'll show you in a separate video. You'll find the link to that video in the description below. I really appreciate you watching my video. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments. Thank you for watching How Fix It, and see you in the next video.